All right, brush shake them.
Oh, brush shake.
Today's sad song is being presented by our beloved brother Maharaji Ra Africa, and he's going to speak to us today on fear and attachment. Maharaji.
Speak. Yeah, I must say that every time you sit in front of a crowd, you always think about what's the first thing I should say. And that's what I'm sitting here saying. What's the first thing I should say? How should I start my sad song?
Let's start with a moment of silence.
Let's start with a moment of silence. Took a few notes, read a few paragraphs, did my 2.5 hours, tried to do a little bit more meditation when I got here. I can say I could have been more prepared to come speak with you. Wants to say they could have been more prepared. They could have been enlightened. They could have did more. It wasn't enough. When you're laying on the bed, about to die. So I'm just simply here to speak with you, talk to you about, to tell you, encourage you, inspire you. Meditate, to simply meditate as instructed. Or to increase your meditation, to encourage you to do more, when we came to the path, or when I came to the path, you know, I had expectations, superstitions, fantasies, beliefs about what this should be, how I saw it before I even encountered the situation. And even in the world, we all have our expectations and beliefs and fantasies and superstitions about the way something should be. And what happens when our expectations and fantasies, superstitions, and beliefs on how something should be doesn't line up with reality or truth leads to suffering. So the question was, did I want to live my life suffering, or did I want to live my life truly happy? Because I know in the end, when we're on our deathbed and we are with our loved ones by our side, when they have the first experience of being powerless, they can't do anything for you. So, take action now. Do what's important. Instead of watching 10 hours of TV, you know, do 10 hours of meditation. Why don't we meditate? What are those things that keeps us from doing our practice, our sadhana, those things that we're attached to after a hard day at work? You come home and I'm tired. I don't need to do any meditation. I need to relax. I need to watch some TV. I need to have a salad. Well, I need to be with my family. I need to be with my wife and my kids. I don't necessarily, I can get to my practice in an hour. And then you know what an hour turns into? An hour turns into another hour. And instead of doing what's important, what's first when you come home, you tend to make this your second priority instead of your first priority. So you must have the right view about the path, about this. Give up all the fears and attachments. Well, your fear could be simply, if I engage in this process wholeheartedly and as instructed, I won't make enough money, or my family, you know, they're going to suffer because I won't be with them. Well, there's going to be a point in time you're not going to be with them anyway, right? So why don't you do what's most important and give them all of you? You follow what I'm saying? Do your practice, give them all of you. Give up that fear. And then what leads to our, or what's beneath our fear, is a lot of times our attachments. Having the right view about things without attachment, about your opinions, your beliefs, situations, your relationships. having the right view is having the view without attachments to your situations, your concepts, your opinions, your relationships. So what I'm saying is my mother sits right here in front of me, and if she says something to me, it's going to have more of an impact emotionally than you, or you, or you. And why is that? Because I'm more attached. I'm more attached to her. It's strange, but once you look at it, everybody's equal, aren't we? Aren't we equal? It's like if I stole a car and went to court, and the judge sentenced me to 3 years in prison. You know, 5 years parole, five months of parole. My mother might come to court, or my father might come to court. Say, oh no, not my son. See, attachment shows up in mine, in my, in why, in my, and he. He shouldn't go to jail, that's my son. But if it was somebody else's son, you wouldn't show to court. Yeah, you wouldn't give a damn. So, having the right view about that situation is to give up the attachment of that relationship. But we are holding on. We don't want to let go. A lot of our fear is based out of attachment. A lot of things that we think that is going to make us happy, we're attached to. And we don't want to let it go. Whether it be sex, money, food, a lot of pleasure, you know. We do it, it lasts 15 minutes, and we get attached to it, so we want it again. Instead of giving that attachment up. It's kind of like alcohol. You know, you keep running back to alcohol. But the secret to detaching from your attachment is to detach and attach to something else. Instead of it being alcohol, it might be coffee. Right? And you have to kind of wean yourself off of that. Instead of eating the chicken and the steak, you might have to eat your soy products. That's a process. All of this is a process. And to have the right view, first you must see it. First you have to, you know, observe your fears, and what's underneath your fear is attachment. See, I never looked at attachment this way. Because sometimes attachment shows up as a duty. I'm not making any money, so I have to go sell drugs. I have to feed my family. But is that right? No, that's wrong. A lot of times your attachment shows up as like I said earlier, oh, I need some rest. I'm gonna watch 10 hours of TV. Is that right? Now, if it leads to you doing more meditation, then it's right attachment. But if it doesn't lead to more meditation, more silence, more practice, then it's wrong attachment. So ultimately, the thing that you want to be attached to is your practice, is the guru. It's those things that that encourage and inspire you to do more practice, to do more meditation. But you have to first see it. You have to see what your attachment is, what your fear is, and that's just observation. Know the truth about yourself. Know what you're attached to. Know your fear. Because everybody's fear might not be yours. So judge ye not one another. Look at yourself. This is self and God realization, observation. Find out what you need to do to increase your meditation, to increase your silence. Not for somebody else, but for you and all sentient beings. Now, you know, when I came to the path, my mother was on the path before me. And I created a concept about what she was doing. I never really understood. I just saw a change. I saw a change in my mother. It was a good change. And what is she doing? She'd go down to the basement early in the morning. I sometimes walk in on her, she have a cover over her head. I thought she was crazy. What are you doing? Doing my meditation. Oh, okay. So I might have been 14, 13, 14, I don't remember. But, I came to a satsang. I remember the master sitting up there. He was all white. He had a white outfit on. And I couldn't, I don't know if I was hearing him or wasn't understanding him. But I fell asleep. It wasn't the right time. Some years went on. My life gradually changed in the opposite direction. And there was something missing. There was something missing. And I didn't know what that thing was. I said, I got a beautiful wife, got a big screen TV, got a new car, I got a newborn baby, I'm living on my own, but it was something missing, and I felt it. People do all sorts of things, to try to cover up that missing feeling. All kind of things to cover up that missing feeling. But it was time then to come home. It was that time. Now I know what that missing feeling was. Now you understand why the things that you used to do and why you did them. And I'm able to not necessarily point the finger, but distinguish why other people do the same thing. And I'm able to speak with them talk to them, relate with them, cope with them, help them. And give them the same chance, the same opportunity that we all to do what's important and then the best for you, not for anybody else, but for you. It's either you're gonna, you know, do your meditation, do your practice, or you're not. That simple. If you don't, you're still gonna die. If you do, you're still gonna die. But you gotta make a decision. Do you wanna live your life truly and really happy? Or do you wanna live a life of suffering? You do the math. Do you wanna lay on the state of Bardo and when you're on your bed, your deathbed, when loved ones are by your side? And through the whole life, they're telling you, why are you talking to this person on the phone every night? Why are you doing so much meditation? Why are you, why aren't you with your family? But when you're on that deathbed, the ones that are by your side are powerless. There's nothing that they can do to save you. So you have an opportunity to save yourself. That's what you have to do, save yourself. The Master talks about this all the time. What are you waiting on? If you have something that's holding you from doing more meditation or meditation as instructed, look into it. Look into why you're and what you are attached to. Look at your fear and distinguish if it's real or is it make-believe. Look at it, observe it, understand it, radical understanding, to the point where 1 + 1 = 2. Because we're all in the same boat. That's why we're here. Isn't it? Maybe for different reasons. Well, it might be the same reason, but we all here in the same boat. We just gotta take advantage and have right use of the situation at hand. And if you can't pinpoint it, that's what your cooler group is for. Your cooler group is here to tell you you're bullshitting. Something ain't right. Because they have no vested interest. They have no commitment of relationship based on sex, money, taking care of bills. They'll tell you the truth. See, because they tell you the truth about how you are, it doesn't matter because they don't have to pay your bills. Your wife or your girlfriend or your children, they might not tell you how you are because that's based on something that's very superficial. could be a risk if they tell you how you are, because you might be tempted to leave that person, or that person leaves you. Or you might not get none for the night. Or a lot of stuff plays into that, but that's what your cooler group is for, to tell you the truth, to help you overcome your fear, overcome your attachments. And I really like the cooler groups now. I really like them, because we get to meditate. I wasn't always the one to talk a lot, because I don't have much to say. But sitting in that meditation and that calmness and that stillness and that peace is liberating. You actually get a chance to do more meditation. Some more reasons why people can't meditate or don't meditate as instructed is because they're mind is full of agitation. It's just agitated. It's just stuff running. Concerns about stuff that's going on around them. And they choose to bring it within them. Now your mind is running. It's agitated. You can't even sit still. Try to sit still. You get up early in the morning, light your incense, sit on your mat, fold your body up in the corner. And you think about yesterday and the day before that. Are you thinking about a year from now? Maya, straight illusion. Does not exist. So you have to create an environment of harmony in your household. You make that room yours. Like retreat, That's one of the things that helped me a great deal. Don't put your concerns, your ego projects, put your things away that try to make people right and wrong, and this and that. Put all that aside. Put that in. Be able to be free from all that for just one moment. Just let all of that go. Your worries, your concerns, your projects. Put all that away. Just be free. Throw it away. And then, once you put your 2.5 hours in, 3 hours, whatever it may be, 4 hours, your hour, and keep that state throughout the day. That meditative state. Now, that's one thing that helped me out a great deal as well. It really opened my eyes. To see that, not how many people I come in contact with, but once I leave a conversation, that conversation is done. I'm back to my mantra, moment to moment to moment. But I wasn't looking at all that at first. I wasn't clear. I wasn't I'd say I'm clear now, and I don't know if I'm straight now, I don't know. I just know that I'm making an effort. You know, that's all I can do. And I asked my cooler mates to serve me, you know, in that manner. And we should serve all of each other in that same way. Help each other. You know, get straight. Help each other, you know, do more meditation. Look at your fears. And if you came to the path and you have a negative belief about the path, it's probably rooted in fear. Look at that. Because if it's negative, then it must be fear. There's something wrong with it if it's negative. So liberate yourself from that. And go on the journey. Just leave all those concerns, your ego projects, your worries. Just throw them in the garbage. Put them in the drawer. Just get rid of them. Because if it's negative, there's no possible way you can be happy. If it's a concern, there's no possible way you can be happy. So get rid of it. What use is it? Is it helping you? Is it? Probably not. That are gonna help you do more meditation. So if you come home and you watch 10 minutes of TV and you're bored because you want to do more meditation, well, come home every day and watch 10 minutes of TV and go do more meditation. Okay? And if your 10 minutes of watching TV turns into 2 or 3, 4 hours and you go to sleep, don't come home and watch 10 minutes of TV. Okay? That person you don't like talking to at work irritates you so bad to go do more meditation. Talk to that person at work. Right. But if that person that you don't like talking to, can't get them out of your mind, and they just lead you to go talk to somebody else about it, stay away from that person. It's the best thing for you to do. Now, fear is one of the things that we had to do consideration on. And a lot of the fear was just created. A lot of it was just make-believe. You know, nobody really looked it down, being in fear. Because nobody really, you know you're going to die. Some people think they're not going to die. They're going to live forever. But nobody's really confronted with it until it's actually them. See people dying all around you. You think it's not going to be you. So it was a lot of fears. You know, it's a whole list of them. They're all connected. You went through the same considerations. And I at the time I was pre-initiated, so I didn't know what to look at. You know, I didn't know where to start. Cooler mates would tell me, nah, is it real or make believe? I really looked at it, this is not real. It doesn't line up with what the Dharma is saying. Then I had to engage in the process and find out that it was, that it really, it was make believe, because I know now it wasn't a belief, it was a, it was known. So to go back to just, you know, fear, just look at your fears. If it's something that is holding you back from your meditation, just look at it, you know, investigate it, and get rid of it. Hit it. Face on. Charge your fear. You know, don't run from it. People come to things and it doesn't line up with their fantasies and their beliefs, their superstitions, and as soon as reality, i.e. truth, doesn't line up with their fantasy, they think there's something wrong. There's something wrong with reality. There's something wrong. It shouldn't be this way. They get mad, they get angry, frustrated, quit. So Bhagwan always tells us, just if you stay in the room, you know, through all that, you know, just stay in the room. And do your meditation. Be happy, truly happy, independently of any situation, place, people, or thing. Do your meditation. You want to be enlightened? You want self and God realization? Do your meditation. If you want to overcome your fears, your attachments, do your meditation as instructed. Are there any questions? Yes, beloved.
What would you say has been your single most greatest fear that you found yourself attached to that you had to give up in order to increase your meditation, and how did you give up?
Myself. Being double-minded. You know, it was more so making my mind up. And recognizing that that I am going to die, you know, that I have to do something about this. You know, my physical death is going to die, and life as I know it, it's not so great. So I had to put my, I guess I had to put my eyes on something greater, you know, than what I was seeing and what I was feeling. I knew it was something missing, so I knew something had to be done. And the fear is the physical death. But if I'm being told, well, life is as I know it, as the physical or ego, you would say, because it's an illusion, is greater than what we're experiencing. There's something greater. That's enough motivation. So I had to make my mind up. Did I want to do that, or did I want to continue living this life the way I was living? That I want something new, that I want something to change. Because things are going to change anyway. It's just, how am I going to, you know, how am I going to view that change? Or how am I going to accept that change? Follow what I'm saying? just it was just making my mind up. And seeing that there was another way, there was a better way. And then all the support and all the help from the people in the house, being here, you know, listening to the words of wisdom, experience, had inspiration. You know, I had a lot of inspiration. Doing the things that I didn't want to do before, now I want to do them. It's just it's like it's no words can't explain it. You know, you don't really know. You can really say it, but you really don't. You know, know. You follow what I'm saying? You know, okay, well, this is my fear, and now I do this, but and you really don't know. You know, it's just I wanted to do it. And that's the long and short of it. You know, I made my mind up.
So her question was, what was the fear that you had to give up? And I still didn't hear you tell me what that was.
The fear?
What was the fear you personally had to give up?
My fear that I had to give up. To do what? To do more meditation.
You're afraid, you were afraid, of, you have a fear. What fear did you have to let go of in order to
improve and improve my meditation? Mm-hmm. To let go. Let go of the bed.
So what was the fear?
Well, what was the fear underneath that?
Attachment.
To the bed.
Okay.
Comfort.
Yeah. Does that answer your question?
Sure.
I mean,
No, I don't think so. That's good.
Another thing I heard you say was that when you looked at your fears, you saw that they were all connected. Can you say a little bit more about that?
Yeah, because one thing led to the next. And then one thing led to something else.
What were they?
And, yeah, it was so long ago, I don't remember exactly what they were. But, you know, you'll make stuff up, you know. This is my fear. And then we had to consider it, is it real or make-believe? And then, once I saw it was, you know, one or the other, you'll come up with something else. You follow what I'm saying? Is it real or make-believe? And then, it kind of was like a trickle-down effect. If you follow what I'm saying? It's kind of like a trickle-down effect. And the majority of them, as I recall, they were all, you know, make believe.
Was those fears that you had, was they real, or do you have a genuine fear that you were really saw that that was genuine fear? I mean, I might have a make believe fear,
right?
And might discover that it's a make believe, but did you ever discover that that it wasn't a make believe fear? That it was genuine fear?
That was real. Have you?
discovered that I had a genuine clear fear. Mm-hmm. Yep. I did.
Is it that the fear is make believe, what is, or the fear was genuine based on a situation that was false? Because, I mean, if you have a fear, the fear is real. But is it based on a situation that was false, not real, or something, a situation you were making up?
Yeah, more making up. It was more created.
But the fear wasn't created, though. And that's what I'm hearing people say, that fear couldn't have been created if the fear was real. But maybe the situation or whatever that caused the fear was just something you made up.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. The situation it might have, like, it's scary sitting here in front of everybody.
That's the creator.
That's the creator. You know what I'm saying? It's created. I can feel my heart, you know, pounding. But when I walk out of here, okay, it's over with. You know, that's what I'm saying. When you really look at it, it's in my mind. I'm identifying with the situation. Which
right,
is,
but the fear was real though, and that's
it's real. It's real.
Right,
it's real to me.
Right, make sure people understand that the fear is real, but maybe what caused the fear is not real.
Right, what caused the fear is not real.
You know
like
what I'm saying?
Because
fear is fear. If you're afraid.
It's been my experience that people have a lot of fears that inhibit them or get in the way of embracing the path. For example, one of my fears was I wasn't going to get enough sleep if I had to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning. That was I'm going to have enough sleep. I'm going to be. That was a fear.
Right.
And for a long while, that got in the way of my practice. I think another fear, and I mean, I've just heard different things, including another fear could be of enlightenment itself, or thinking that I'm going to do all of this and it still may not happen. So some of these fears can be real subtle. And so I think when people are asking you what your fear was.
I guess then you say it was the fear of not knowing. The fear of fear.
The fear of not knowing
what may be true.
Okay. As far as the path is concerned.
You follow what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
What you just mentioned, that may be true, but you don't know if it's true until you actually do it.
Yeah, beloved brother, I'm listening to your argument and your discourse, and I can say, at this level of your existence, have you overcame your fears?
Not all.
I wanted to read something to you that I took notes in, you know, some Hindu texts. And it's fearlessness in the Hindu term is abhaya. And it says, fear is integral to the individualized human existence. As the ancients said, fear arises when there is another. Fearlessness is the fruit of perfect self-realization or enlightenment, i.e. the recovery of non-duality. So I just wanted to share that with you.
So it did mention that a fear is connected to another fear.
Right. Mm-hmm. You feel as there is another one, because I can say, if you're at a state of non-duality, then what is there for the fear? You know that you're the one and only.
Right.
So
right.
It's, you know.
Right. Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Is it, you had a question?
Nah.
Oh, okay.
But I asked
that
the question first.
Okay. Yeah, I like that, man. It sounded good. Thank you.
I know that what you just said was that fearlessness comes when there is no duality.
Right.
So the bottom line is we're probably going to all have some fears and continue to have them until we become enlightened.
Mm-hmm. That's integral. and the human experience.
Because he's saying it's integral. It's, in other words, that is the experience of the ego. And so we're going to all have fears. And when they kept asking you, what was your fear? I kept saying to myself, wow, it's like 15 million of them. So which one is he going to get done and ask me about? I don't know. But anyway, I was thinking to myself, where's my fear? And I was thinking, oh, it's about 15 million of them. So, and they just continue to come as I live in this world. And so.
It can be feared at that moment.
It's fear constantly. And you're right, sometimes it is the experience that you're having, it's all made up. It's all made up, and you're thinking that it's real.
And a lot of times we're driven out of fear. Mm-hmm. You know, we do things because of fear.
Mm-hmm. And you don't do things because of fear.
And sometimes you run from it as well. So.
I think the main thing is just to make up your mind and just don't ask yourself about meditation. Just get up just like you do as a robot. I get up, brush my teeth, do this, and go do your meditation just like that. Because until you keep doing it that way, it just seems like you let the other things get involved where it stops you. So it's almost like you can't be thinking about, you know, well, I'm tired, this, that, and other. You just have to get up and just do it, just like you do everything, all the other things that you're attached to.
Spoken like a true new person.
But true.
Yes, but true. True. Give up thy fear and do thy devotion.
Do it. And I'm talking to myself now.
Yep. Do your meditation. Use your cooler mates to tackle your fear, to pinpoint your fears, your attachments. And do the meditation. That's all I'm here for, to, you know, to be your server, to help support you in any way I can. Give you words that, inspire you, encourage you, do the things that are important, put away the things that are not. When you meditate, put all your concerns and your projects, put them away and concentrate. And could it be that your fear and all the things that are keeping you from your meditation will show up in your meditation. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All your agitated thoughts and concerns, your greed, your lust, your anger, your vanity, your attachments will show. It's kind of like shining a light down a well. See all this slime start to crawl up. So take a look at it. Pinpoint it. And conquer it. Any more questions? How much time do we have?
No more questions. You can wrap it.
5 minutes. So,
I wasn't at your initiation, and maybe there are others here that were not. Can you tell me what your name means, Maharaji?
Maharaji.
What does that mean?
Means grace and mercy.
Grace and mercy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
One that's able to recognize grace.
Okay. Thank you.
So we're going to meditate. Right after this, right?
Yeah.
That's even better. Good. So we can all practice on what I was talking about, right? That would be nice.
Do you have music?
Yeah, I thought we were going to play the music before. I guess.
It's okay.
Play it now. All right, they all fussed it out, so
oh.
You don't have to just drag it out.
Good.
Thank you.
see.
Not afraid anymore.
Stop smoking cigarette, they won't even realize they got a cigarette in their hand.